Hi, I'm Trent Fuller. I'm from Atlanta. I love Fastest and Fourth here, so I'm just so happy to be here.
Anya at no point asked me if I wanted a sandwich as well. Otherwise, Fest has been amazing.
Chili dog, outside chase to freeze. Why does he say that? It's been like 30 years and I still can't. Does he suck on a chili dog? Is that what he does? Ladies, if your man sucks on a chili dog, he's a freak. Not the good kind either. Call the cops immediately, seriously. What's up, y'all?
Hello. So I'm getting older and I am still unwed, and I'm finding that the older I get, the fewer the fish in the sea, and because of that, the lower my standards are getting. They're plummeting rapidly. And I realized that when I started watching the show Mindhunter. Has anybody in here seen the show Mindhunter? Okay, a few people. If you haven't seen it, it's on Netflix. It's really good. It's about the FBI program in the late 70s and early 80s when they would interview serial killers in prison to create a profiling system to catch bad guys before they do bad things, and it's really good. And one of the first episodes, the lead FBI agent goes to his partner, and he's like, I'm going to interview Ed Kemper. And his partner's like, are you fucking kidding me? You're going to interview 6'9" Ed Kemper, who murdered his own grandparents in cold blood at the age of 15, and then murdered and raped college girls, and finally murdered and decapitated his own mother? Are you fucking kidding me? And I was at home like, did you say 6'9"? I could fix him, for sure I could fix him. I got straight A's in school, I love a good group project. And here's the thing, is like men claim that they hate it, they're like, oh, she's trying to fix me, she's trying to change me. Yeah, of course we are, because you suck. And you know what, if you don't like it so much, then give me all my pillows back. Because before women, all men just lived with one sad flat pillow on their bed, like they just got out of prison or something. Here I am. I am chill, dude, but that I'm sometimes too chill. Maybe need to get my life together. Have you guys ever been so far behind on laundry that you had to dress up to leave the house? There's like way past fucking sweatpants day, way past Halloween costume day. You know, you're just like, oh fuck, I guess I'm wearing my prom dress to my pap smear. Yes, that's where I'm at. Sorry, it's pink and ruffly. I hope you can find your way down there. Super good. My grandma's always telling me I need to get my life together. Anybody have those women in your life whose love language is criticism? Anyone? Okay, we all do. I can see it on your clothes. That's great. Yeah, my grandma always saying some shit. I went over to her house the other day. We're going to lunch. She's like, we're going to lunch. You didn't do your hair for me? You didn't do your hair for me? It's like, no, grandma, I didn't do my hair for you. I'm not trying to fuck you. What I am, you'll know, baby doll. I'll lean into a kiss. Okay, not weird.
But prior to this weekend, I've been putting some work into my body, working out, eating right, doing that sort of shit. I've lost like 40 pounds. Woo! Which is, thank you. I put 20 back on this weekend. That's cool. I'm very brave. And here's the thing. I realized it was time for me to start losing weight when I discovered that the way that I have sex and the way that I swim were becoming very much the same. It's a doggy style shirt on. It's the same. If you didn't laugh just now, it's because you didn't picture it. Go ahead, get an image in your minds. Did you picture me swimming or fucking?
Hello, everybody!
Hello!
Okay, cool. I just like to know that you're awake, battling a crippling hangover. Like, that's, I like to know my people are here. I don't know. I'm trying to be a better person. I listen when people talk. I realize I'm an hourly presenting straight white man. I gotta do better. We've committed a lot of crimes. We've started all the wars. We wrote the song Honky Tonk Badonkadonk. We have things to apologize for. So what I did this year to be a better man, guys, I gave away my acoustic guitar. Thank you. If you don't understand that, when every white man turns 12, they're just given a fucking acoustic guitar. and then it sits in the corner of your apartment like a silent threat. Like you better listen to me talk about Bernie Sanders, I'm gonna play a Sublime song at you.
I'm at the financial point in my life where even if I got food poisoning from Taco Bell, I'd still eat there the next day. And I only know this because it's happened to me twice already. But, they recently announced you can get married at Taco Bell in Las Vegas for $600. And about 45 people posted it on my Facebook wall like I hadn't seen it already. And I just thought it was weird that these people thought I had $600 too.
Do you guys like my fest cropped sweatshirt? Are you feeling it? This is my attempt at looking like a hot little slut. But instead, it kind of just looks like I'm a child who grew up today. And didn't have time to go home and change.
No, I worked for Five Star Pizza for about 25 minutes. That's one delivery, not a great track record. I showed up to my first day, thinking I was going to have to go through training and stuff. Nope. I was stoned out of my mind on the first day. And I walk in, and they hand me a five-star shirt, and they give me a pizza, and they go, the address is on the box. Good luck. Like, fuck. So I'm driving to this girl's house to drop her pizza off, and I hit a really long red light. And I look down, and in the ashtray of my car was half a joint. And jackpot! So I smoked it and got problem high. I got so problem high that I just drove home. I was pulling in my driveway, and I was like, oh my God, what smells delicious? Did I will that pizza into existence? Was hanging out with my friends the next day, told them the story about how I got stoned and went home and ate the pizza, and they decided to be real dicks about the scenario, so they called and ordered five-star to my house and didn't tell me. So somebody knocks on the door, I go and answer it, it's a five-star driver. He's like, hey man, didn't you start working at five-star yesterday and then just steal a pizza? And I was like, oh no, I just have like a really familiar looking face. And he's like, yeah, but we don't sell those shirts.
Don't worry, I'm a professional comedian. I'm also a musician. Woo! So yeah, so basically, I'm a bartender with no health insurance. Yeah. I recently came out to my family. Yeah. I wish they had reacted that way. I recently came out to my family as a stand-up comedian. They were pretty disappointed. But not as disappointed as if I had come out as an improv comedian. Because, you know, there's a hierarchy. And it goes improv, stand-up. Actually, it goes magician, improv comedian, stand-up. Actually, at the bottom, you have DJ apprentice, magician, improv comedian, stand-up comedian. And at the top, you have employed. That's how that works.
For the first time ever last night, a guy came up to me and he told me that I should smile. Ugh. Guys, don't fucking do that. I had never heard that in my life, but I instantly got offended, but I didn't know what to say. All I think to say to him was like, why? That was my big comeback. I was like, why? And he was like, because you're the hostess at this restaurant. And I'm your boss. I'm gonna have to let you go. Men are pricks, right, ladies? Go gay, that's what I say. No? Okay, got them. They're all straight in here.
Terrible person, and no one cares what I have to say.
Perfect, perfect one.